for today, we will discuss about reading whole numbers. Okay, ito nga. So, reading whole numbers. Ang pag-uusapan natin ngayon sa mga. So, we talk about how to read and how to write whole numbers. So, now, to convert a number that is formed by digits into a verbal phrase, use the following methods. So, meron tayong mga methods on how to convert a number in digits into a verbal phrase. Ito po, digits. And then, verbal phrase. Balik tayo. Use the following method. So, beginning at first one, we have beginning at the right and working right to left. Separate the number into distinct periods by inserting commas every 3 digit. Okay, in every 3 digit, kailangan beginning at the right and working right to left, isi-separate ninyo yung number into a distinct periods by inserting commas. Sa pamamagitan ng commas, makikita natin yung pagkakahiwalay ng numbers sa kanilang periods. Pag sinabi natin periods, yan yung place value. From ones, tens, hundred thousands, ten thousands, hundred thousands, and so on. So, yan yung periods. Okay? Paano mahihiwalay? By inserting commas every 3 digits. Next, beginning at the left, read each period individually saying the period name. Okay, simula daw sa kaliwa, read each period individually saying the period name. Yung period, halimbawa, ang given, ano natin, given number is 25. Umpisa natin sa left. Hindi naman tayo pwede mag-umpisa sa right. So, mag-umpisa tayo sa right, sa left pala, sorry, sa left. Mag-umpisa tayo sa left para basahin yung number. Let's say 25 na number. We have 25. So, yun yung pagbag on how to read properly in whole numbers. Next. Okay, balik tayo. So, we have sample here. Sample set A here. Okay, sample set A here. We have, write the following numbers as words. Kung nakikita ninyo, meron tayo dyang read. Ayan. Medyo malaki-laki ng numbers nito. So, we have here. Okay, malaki to. So, yan. Read. Yan, kung ano nakikita ninyo yung numbers sa screen. So, solution, we have here, step 1. So, you have on how to read whole numbers first. So, step 1, we have beginning at the right. We can separate this number into a distinct periods by inserting a comma between the 2 and 9. So, hihiwalayin natin yung 2 at 9. So, ito yun. Hihiwalayin natin yung periods by yung periods na tinutukoy dito, hindi tuldo ka, yung periods, yun yung sinasabi ko kanina, place value. So, yung periods na yun, hihiwalayin natin yun sa pamamagitan ng comma, which is 2 and 9. Yan, ito yun, nakikita nyo sa baba. 2 at 9, naglagay tayo ng comma, pati rin dito sa kabila, ito, 2 at 9. So, yan yun. Eka, parang ano to. So, dapat ito ay, wait. So, yun, 2 and 9. Ito yun. Yung step, dun to sa step A. Parang may mali dito sa aking, ano. Anyway, tingnan natin yung set next one. So, ito yun ha. Dapat hiwalay yan. So, dapat tatlo to. Take the tatlo. So, dapat, yung kamat pala dito ay mapupunta dito sa 4. Sa pagitan ng 4 at 2. Okay, 4 at 2. Yung itong first comma ay mapupunta dito sa may sa between 4 and 2. Okay, 4 and 2, yan. Yan. So, magiging 4,295,842,958 dapat yan. So, yun. 99 po ba yun? So, yan yun. Next, lipat na yun sa kabila. Medyo nagahang. Ito. Step 2. Ito yung step 2 natin. So, we have here yung ating step 2. Okay, ito na yung step 2. Beginning at the left, we read each period individually. So, yan. Meron ditong pictures. So, on first picture, we have 3, 0, tsaka 7. Nasa million periods yan. how do we write or how do we read this number? Yung 307 na nasa millions period. We have here 307 million. So yan ang basag dyan. Kasi nasa millions period tayo at nasa hundreds place to. So ang basag dyan is 307 million. Next, dito tayo sa baba. We have 991, pero nasa thousands period. We have 991,000. Okay, kasi nasa thousands period siya. Then, the last one, we have the units period. We have 343. So, yon 343. So, ang basa dyan is 307,991,343. So, yan yun. Next, ito na naman, medyo mahirap to. Sample set letter A uli. So, we have here, read. Oh, nakikita nyo yung numbers dyan. Yan, puro siya zero, ang dami. So, we have, yan, numbers na yan. So, we have here the solution. We have step 1, beginning at the right. Dito tayo mag-uumpisa sa right, ha? Ito yung left, ito yung right. Okay, dito tayo mag-uumpisa. Beginning at the right, we can separate this number into distinct periods by placing comma. So, ito. So, we have, mag-ano tayo ng periods, di ba? Ang periods natin ay yung units periods, thousands period, then millions period. So, meron tayo munang units. Ang units period natin ay may tatlo. Ones, tens, and hundreds. So, ito yun. So, ones, tens, and hundreds. Pagkatapos ng hundreds, comma na. After ng comma, pupunta na tayo sa thousands period. Ito na yung thousand, hundred thousand, tenta. Ito, sorry, we have thousands, ten thousands, and hundred thousands, and then comma. Susundan ng millions period, we have 1 million, 10 million, 100 million, comma uli. Then we have here, billions na tayo. So, 1 billion, 10 billion, 100 billion, ayan na, comma uli. So, yun na, tapos na tayo. So, doon na tayo magkakama. After ng dito, sa pagitan ng 6 at 0. Yan. Yan, dito na tayo magkakama. So, yun, that's it. So, step 2, beginning at the left, we read each period individually. Tapos na tayo sa right, sa left naman tayo. How do we read this number? Ang laki, di ba? Sige, malalaman natin kung paano basahin yan. So, meron tayong 5 periods. We have the trillions period, billions period, millions period, thousands period, and units period. So, how do we read that? So, we have here 36 trillion 1. Bakit naging 1? Kasi nga, yung billions period natin, yung millions period at thousands period ay nasa 0. 0 lagi. Pero ang natirang digit ay dito ay 1. So, ang basa po dyan ay 36 trillion 1. Okay? May tanong. Any questions? Kung wala, discuss. Next. Now, let's discuss about the writing whole numbers. How do we write whole numbers? So, to express a number in digits that is expressed in words, use the following methods. So, notice first that a number expressed as a verbal phrase will have its period set off by commas. Okay? Starting at the beginning of the phrase, write each period of number individually. So, yan ang on how to write whole numbers. Next, using commas to separate periods, okay? Combine the periods to form one number. Ito na, pupunta na tayo sa sample set B. So, ngayon, nakikita nyo dito ay, ano na siya, words. Hindi na siya numbers. So, we have 7,092. Pinaghihiwalay sila ng comma. Okay, pinaghihiwalay sila ng comma kasi nga iba-iba yung kanilang period. The solution is using the comma as a period separator. Gagamitin natin tong si comma para mahiwalay uli natin. So we have here, yan. We have here 7,000, ayan si 7 tsaka si 92. 92 lang kasi siya dahil wala siyang hundreds place. So kung walang hundreds place yan, you are going to write 0 here and then tens place, we have 92, yan. Tens place and ones place. So, kung walang hundreds place yun, 0 siya, edi lagay nyo 0. Yan yun. We have here 7,092. Next, sample set B. We have here 50,000,000, 1,200,014. Ayan. Hiwalay-hiwalay yan. May tatlo tayong period uli dyan. Billion, million, thousands place, and then the units period. Apat pala, sorry. Apat ang periods. Now, how do we transform this into a numbers? Okay, paano natin ito transform yan? So, using the commas as period separators. So, gagamitin natin si comma. Ito, si comma ito. Gagamitin natin yan para makasulat tayo ng numbers. So, we have here, yan. Take a look at the image. 50 billion, ito yon 50. 1 million, ito. 1 million, ito lang. Magkamali kayo. Then, 200,000, ito yon. And then, 14, ito yon. 50 million, 1 million, 214. So, that's it. Ayan. Sample set B. Meron pa again. Another example, we have 10,512. How do we write this one into a words? So, the comma sets of the periods, we notice that there is no thousand periods. We'll have to insert this ourselves. Papansin ninyo dito sa sample set B na to, wala siyang thousands period. Pero ilalagay natin pa rin yan. Paano? Paano natin ilalagay yung thousands period kung wala naman siyang binangge? Ito. So, meron tayong 10 million. Ayan yan. 0,000. Ito. Dahil wala siyang binanggit na thousands period, we are going automatically into a 0. 0 na to. And then we have 512. So, yan. 10,512. So, that's it. So, yan yung pagkaka on how to write and how to read whole numbers. So, now, get your papers and then let's have your activity. So, for the first activity, we have, you are going to express each number using digits. So, you are going to transform these words into a numbers. Okay. Yan ang gagawin ninyo. Next, yan na, we have 103,025. Madali lang to. Next, 6,040,007. Ito, medyo mahirap yung number 3. We have 20,380,109,402. And then the last one, we have the 80,035. Next one, we have the last, the activity we have. Ang gagawin nyo naman dito is, you are going to transform these numbers in words. Pero dito, meron tayong makikita parang problem, ano dito, parang problem solving siya. Kung makikita nyo yung may numbers dito, you are going to transform these, the numbers, into a words. Okay? Naintindihan po ba? So, yan. For the following problems, write all numbers in words. So, the first one, we have 912. Second one is 1,491. Third one, we have that a particular community college has 12,471. Itong number na to. Yan. Ito, 12,471. And then the fourth one, we have here the 9,690. Ito. Transform this. And then the last one is the 20. So, yun lang. So, that's it. So, yan lang ang ating lesson for today is all about the reading whole numbers. So, yan ang tapos na ang ating i-discuss. So, yan ang ating discussion for today.